Today we're looking at choosing an LED dimmer and how to set the low-end dim level. So what do you want to look at first?
Well, if it was me choosing a dimmer, Gary, the first thing I'd be thinking about is that electrical load.
Okay, so we all know that LEDs are a lot less wattage. Is that really important when selecting your dimmer?
Well, it is. It's reflected in the dimmer, and you know there's a lot of dimmers out there at the minute, and some will still work on traditional lamps, but some are specifically designed for LED loads themselves.
Okay, so I'm going to look at my dimmer itself, and it should give me some indication on the lowness of the wattage as well as the maximum.
Yeah, well, let's have a look at this one from Hamilton, Gary.
Okay, I'll bring the camera
in. This is one we've been using quite a bit through this series, so we'll see. This is the LEDITB. I don't want you to break out into song at that point, Gary.
Okay.
But you'll see this is specifically for LED lamps or LED drivers. It has a range of between 5 and 100 watts, but also interestingly, actually a limit on the number of LED lamps as well.
Maximum of 10 there.
Yeah, so in the case of many of the lamps we've been using in this series are just over 5 watts.
They are.
So you could only load it up to around 50 watts of LED load.
Okay, so we could have one of those lamps on, not a problem, because they're 5.5 above the 5 watt, but up to a maximum of 10 of those, even though that would be well under the 100 watts it suggests it can cater.
Yeah, and that changes by manufacturer. Some dimmers are rated up to 150 watts and don't make any specific mention of lamps. There are, however, things to look for and compatibility charts, both on the lamp side and the driver side. Most people don't look at that until it's too late. So hopefully you'll learn some of those through watching this video.
Okay, so we're gonna select a dimmer based on the wattage of the lamps we're gonna install and the maximum number of those lamps. Where do we go next?
Okay, so the next thing I'd be worrying about is obviously the depth behind it, you know, the recessed depth you need to fit that into. So obviously it's not a problem necessarily on a new build, providing you think ahead and get the right depth of backbox, but if you're going to retrofit a dimmer to an existing installation, that can trip you up.
That's a really good piece of information, because they are a lot deeper. You got one there you want to show me?
Yeah, so here's this one we're calling our mystery dimmer.
Okay.
So you can see that, and then put comparing it to an Aurora dimmer there, and our Hamilton dimmer, you'll see they are significantly deeper than a normal light switch.
Absolutely, so that box has got to be probably 25 mil or greater in depth, do you agree?
Yeah, certainly, and then obviously watching where the cables are coming out the back as well, so you might need a bit of extra room to allow them to curve around.
Okay, so another top tip there then.
Yeah, and then obviously that's traditional plate switch dimmers, lots of decorative finishes available, but then think about those grid switches.
Okay, so yeah, that would be, you know, you've got a grid switch, say of 10, maybe in a public house, and you're changing those lamps over to dimmable ones. Oh, you've got 9 other switches and you've got to retrofit a dimmer in there. That could be a painful experience.
Yeah, and luckily a lot of the manufacturers have thought of that, so you can buy your dimmer module and some adapter plates to set to fit different types of grid switch systems that are out there.
Right.
In front of you, Gary.
Right, let's have a look at this full collection here.
So we found this one from Selectric, and they possibly produce one of the widest range. There's almost every conceivable option of grid there, from MK grids, Crabtree grids, Click Scolmore, and BG, and obviously their own version as well.
And they were all in the one packet with the one dimmer, is that true?
Yeah, it was, yeah. So that's you can put one of those in the back of your van, and you're kind of covered for almost every eventuality.
I'm not suggesting the amount of plastic that's gone in there when you might only need one, but of course we'd always like your comments below on things like that as well. Okay, so we've got the depth, we've got the wattage rating, we've got the ability to retrofit it, say when we're looking at putting it in a grid system. Where do you want to go next?
Okay, so let's think about that next topic, and this makes the biggest difference in installation. It's setting that low-end dim level. So how low can you take the light level?
Okay, so we can talk about when we roll the dim around, are we going to go completely off? Probably not. We're going to set it at the lowest level that we're acceptable, so every time we turn it on and off, it'll only go to that point. Is that true?
Yeah, we hope so anyway. So let's have a little look. I've paired the Hamilton dimmer with the V-Tac lamp. So let's just check the low end first. So try that. Yeah, so it's not low enough. So we're probably going to have to make some adjustments. So we do that, we switch the dimmer on, and then turn it down to the minimum level, switch it off, switch it back on, turn it up to maximum, switch it off, switch it back on. Dimmer gives a little flash to say it's in programming mode. Then we dial down to our low end setting, get somewhere nearly where we're acceptable. just final tweak, then switch off and switch on again. And the lamp has memorized that setting, gives us a little flash to tell us that. And there we've made that adjustment on this dimmer to set the low end dim level. So let's just check we're happy with that. Yeah, so that's nicely set. Again, just check that it comes back on once we've done it. Yeah, we'll set up.
Okay, so that's all right. Well, you've got the instructions. I would say another top tip, keep the instructions, or as always, have your go-to dimmer and maybe your go-to lamps would be another top tip. So there was some sequence of pressing there in the instructions in order that you found the low end?
Yeah, so found the low end. There's some other settings in there. You can set the mode of operation. So this dimmer supplied default as a trailing edge dimmer.
Right.
You may, in some rare circumstances, perhaps you've got some halogen lamps, want to set to a leading edge dimmer. You okay. can do that with a with another few tweaks and twists and off and on combination to do that. But that was the V-Tac lamp. So if you remember, check out our previous video where we looked at dimming performance. We'll see that the V-Tac lamp dimmed at the bottom end of the dimming curve, so the low part of the AC waveform. Well, let's swap over, Gary, and pair it back up with our Osram lamp supplied by Ledvance that needed to dim quite high up in the dimming curve. So we'll probably need to reset the dimmer for that.
So that's still going to be the Hamilton dimmer, but we're going to change the lamps.
Yeah.
And wouldn't it be ideal if already when you change it over, it's actually set at the right positions, but we're probably thinking it isn't going to be, is it, Gordon?
No. So let's have a look at that. So again, so now swapped over to our Ledvance lamp. Again, let's have a look at that dim curve. So I'm dimming down to a low end and you'll see at the bottom, it's actually gone off.
Ah, right. Okay.
So that's not acceptable. Probably in most installations, you probably want to get that full range on the dimmer switch and not have that suddenly plunging people into darkness.
Are you going to have to go back through the same routine again?
Yeah, so same routine again. So again, switch the lamp on at full power. And just turn down to the minimum setting. Switch off, switch on. Turn it up to full, switch off,
okay.
Switch on. Lamp gives us a little indication.
Good.
There we go, we're into programming mode.
And that gives you a chance at that bottom end.
Yeah, turn it back, dial it to somewhere where we're happy, so the lamp's just on. Okay, switch off, switch back on again. Should get a little hint that it's memorized that. There we go, there it is. And then we've memorized our dim level, so we've got nice smooth low-end dimming on that lamp as well.
All right, okay, it seems simpler the second time round, didn't it? Once you got your on, your offs and ups and downs. So, yeah, that's really good. So the Hamilton one there was set with, first of all, was it Ledvance you said?
The V-Tac first.
V-Tac first, yeah. And then Ledvance second,
yeah,
yes.
Yeah, but you'll notice each lamp has a different low end.
It does.
So if you were in an installation and you'd suddenly decided to swap lamps, you'd probably have to reconfigure your dimmer to match those options.
So that's a classic, isn't it? Maybe three or four lamps have gone out of, say, six. You replace all of them to think you'll start again from fresh. If you haven't got exactly the same lamps you had before, you're probably going to have to go through the routine on the dimmer.
Yeah, so don't lose those instructions.
No. And we've felt that pain, haven't we, down this end, haven't we? Not anyone with a set of instructions. So where do you want to go next? And should we do another one?
Yeah, so that's one way of doing it. So the twist, flash, remember the combinations. There is a simpler way in some dimmers.
Oh, right, I like that already.
And that's to remove the switch, and there's normally a little potentiometer on the back that you can set.
Right.
So let's have a look at that on this Aurora dimmer.
Before we do that, we're going to have to obviously have it, I would imagine, live in order to use that little screw behind it to set the low end.
Yeah, so that is the slight downside of that method. Yeah, you can't do that. You can't do that as a fully isolated. You're going to have to be livened up with the lamps in circuit so you can see both at the same time.
Okay, so top tip for us would be obviously to isolate the supply, take the cover off, check your terminations are nice and tight and they're not going to fly out the back before you do anything else. Then you're going to have to energize it under control conditions and just make that adjustment. I would suggest this is for electrical contractors only, where maybe the previous one was something maybe a customer could do as well. So let's have a look at that then. So first of all, you're going to get this, we're going to go with the Aurora, aren't we? You're going to take the Aurora cover off and show us it on this one. I notice you've got your favorite tool out, Gordon.
Yeah, I've got the old Speedy 2. Never miss an opportunity to get that out of the cupboard.
So cover comes off. And then we're into the next part of the process. So, covers off. We're gonna.
Again, so I'm checking that low end. So again, not happy with the low end, so I'm going to have to make some adjustments to it.
It's hardly moving at all, is it? I mean, the low end's not very good
so
at all.
Flip the dimmer over, and the back, you'll see the little white potentiometer in there.
Yeah.
Going with a very small tip screwdriver. They are quite fragile, so watch that. Just make tweak the adjustment that you want on that. And then it'd be a case of, yeah, happy with that. And then just do a little final check. And then you'd be screwing that dimmer back to the wall. Just check it goes off and on. Just check that level. Happy with it. Switch it off. Switch it back on again. You see, you have to give it a little tweak for that to restart up. You sometimes do see that.
That seems simple enough. I like that one.
You like that one?
I mean, press, roll, press, go again. Obviously, if you haven't got the instructions, obviously that's going to be one of those ones you're going to have to dig around on the internet to find. Whereas obviously the Aurora one, having that adjustment on the back, but of course there's an element of working live. Is there any others you want to have a go at?
Okay, well, let's have a look at the Selectric one, which again, so that's back to the twist and flash method.
Right, okay, so we're going to do the Selectric one. Which lamps are these with?
So we've paired that up with the Philips lamps.
Okay.
So again, it's a similar procedure. So on this one, again, we're checking that low end level, not quite low enough, so we're gonna have to reprogram it. So in this case, it's a case of turning it to full, turning it back to minimum, off and on twice. Lamp gives you a little indication that it's in a programming mode. And then we set the low end that we want.
Okay.
And then we just wait 3 seconds. It flashes to say that's been stored. And then that's the low end set in that dimmer. So a different method to what we had earlier.
Okay, and then once you've got it, obviously you'll just confirm that full brightness and the low end as well.
Just check the low end, and I always like to just switch off and back on again just to make sure that it has stored it and we're happy with that and everything's working.
Okay, so again, know your dimmer, keep the instructions. Obviously, if it's your go-to dimmer, you're going to be pretty familiar with the button pressing.
You're going to remember that. And in the Selectric one, yeah, there's all sorts of other, again, combinations to set leading edge or trailing edge. They have 3 modes of operation. And there's also, if you completely mess it up, which is highly likely when we're involved, there is a reset to factory default options you get into a world of trouble.
So that's a few of them we've done. Are we going to do one more?
Yeah, so we'll do 2 more again.
Oh, we're 2
the
more.
The last one is really easy.
Okay, I'll do the last one.
Before we get to that one, let's have a look at this Knightsbridge dimmer. So this is with a decorative style faceplate. So again, just to remove the front slightly different, pull the potentiometer knob off, jack off the front cover, and then remove the screws that are underneath the decorative faceplate. And hopefully by the time we've done that, we will reveal that it has, similar to that previous dimmer, a little potentiometer underneath where we can set that dimmed level.
So same rules apply, turn it off, check your terminations, obviously work under control conditions, because in a minute that's going to be energized in order to set it. Okay.
Yeah, so there again, so we've got our switch there. So we've paired this with the Knightsbridge's own lamp.
Okay.
So hopefully that should be an ideal combination. If you make the dimmer and the lamp, you'd want them to work pretty well together.
Okay.
So again, just tweak that low end until you're at a happy level. I'd suggest not dimming to off, because you can get some other strange phenomenon occur in that. So happy with that. Yeah, tweak that low end. So yeah, that's acceptable performance.
I like those ones, nice and simple, but again, very difficult for the customer to do it or even bespoke about it over the phone. You're obviously going to have to turn up on site if you had to reconfigure the dimmer in that one. So you said we've got one more then, mystery dimmer.
Yeah, the mystery dimmer I have paired up behind us with the V-Tac lamps that we saw earlier. And the only challenge with the mystery dimmer, Gary, is you can't set the low end on it.
Oh, right. Okay. So either works or it doesn't.
Yeah, that's it.
So which set of lamps will bring them up above me? So which set of lamps have you done up there?
See, I've done those with the V-Tac lamps.
Okay, bring them down then.
And yeah, that's as low as you can go. I mean, it's quite a good combination. It's almost like they were made to work together. But that's not necessarily the case with all lamps, as we found in a previous video. Check that out if you haven't seen that already.
All right, so we've actually set all of these. So we've shown the switch, the knob, turn around, and the potentiometer. Have I said that right? Yeah, in order to set the low end on these. Shall we see all the low ends at one go?
So you bring in the lamp cam.
Okay, so the lamps are all above us. Okay, do you want to set all of those down to the low end?
I'll put them all up full first.
All right, we're going to be flicking around with brightness. I apologise about that.
So and then, yeah, we can, we just can
bring them down.
Dial those down. That's the mystery dimmer with the V-Tac lamps. That's the Knightsbridge with the Knightsbridge lamps. The Aurora with the Aurora lamps. The Selectric with the Philips lamps. And the Hamilton LEDITB with the Osram lamps supplied by Ledvance.
That's quite a nice full set of low ends as well. They're pretty similar.
Yeah, and you probably don't see on the camera there that actually they are significantly lower than the probably, you know, the light conditions you see on the camera.
Quite bright as well. That's excellent. I think that's pretty much covered everything we need to know about setting that low end. And again, it's like I reiterated again, know your dimmer, know your lamp.
Yeah, and watch out for the certain things of personal preference. You know, do you want your lamps to actually dim to off, or do you just want them to go to a min level? And depending on the application, check what happens when you switch the lamp back on.
Yeah.
Because some will instantly start at a lower level. Some of them you need to give a little tweak.
Yeah, a little nudge.
And then set them back down to a lower level. And obviously that could change, depends on what else is happening in the house. We haven't tried it here, but if someone's got the induction hob on, the hot tub outside, you've got an area where there's volt drop. And
that low end could be in a little bit of trouble if you're right at the very low end.
Yeah, so I'd suggest if it's super critical, you're always dim to low end, you probably need to look at a different technology, not lamp and dimmer combinations. You probably want to be dedicated fittings. You might be looking at something like Dali, and that's a completely different world that we're not looking at in this video.
As always, we're interested in your comments on any of the subjects we've covered on LED and dimming LED and all the problems that it may have or may not have. What are your feelings? What problems have you had in the past? What's your go-to dimmer? What's your go-to lamp? Please leave those comments below and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.